Okay, so I'm getting ready to open a virgin can of Waterlox here. It's always a pleasure. And you really want to be careful. You can just pitch this and throw it away. I never use them again. But you want to be careful to kind of open this real carefully. So you just a nice flat screwdriver, because this is going to be what's going to reseal your can time and time again, and you want to save that. And you'll notice that this is offset, and it's offset for a reason. So when you pour it like this, it just is going to glug out and make a mess. But if you pour it over like this, you can pour with just absolute control and not waste one drop. That should be enough to get started. And I always put the cap back on, because I am kind of a klutz in my small shop where I can knock it over, and I'll just try to set it out of the way. So here we go. Look at that. That's gorgeous. Yeah, and the beauty of this product is you can't over brush it. You can just keep, if you get too much on, you can just keep working it until you thin it out, until it starts getting spread it out. It's just, it will never alligator on you or do anything bad. It's completely foolproof. And if you come back and you realize you've got a spot that's got over finish on it, but the finish hasn't set yet, you can always just reapply a little bit to your brush and come in and heat it up and use the solvent nature of the finish to spread that out. So it's very foolproof. I've had this sprayed and have sprayed it. You can't put enough on with a spray gun. You end up, I think that it's probably like a 4-to-1 for spray application than what I can brush. And so it just is a pain with all the cleaning of the spray guns, and so I don't do it. So there, I got a uniform saturated coat on this side. Now I'm gonna flip them now. Most people, when you say it and they don't know about it, because it has water in the name, they think it's a water-based finish, and it's definitely not. It's a tung oil-based product with mineral spirits as a solvent and a vehicle. So that's what's gonna evaporate out and be the volatile organic smell that will irritate you if you don't wear a respirator indoors. But the other incredible thing about this is, and I'll show you in this video, I'll show you something, a mahogany piece, a bedside table that I know is 15 years old and still looks fantastic. And the beauty of this is unlike polyurethane, where you can't ever go back in and just scratch polyurethane and reapply a coat if the finish gets dull or damaged, Waterlox, all you have to do is go back in, scratch the surface, get the surface dirt off, and reapply a coat, and the solvent nature of it will just bleed right into the previous coat, and it will just rejuvenate it. So you can do it with, if you have Waterlox floors in your home or furniture. And one of the ways I first learned about this is I had a retail space when I first started selling furniture to the public. I had a retail space where there were a lot of antique dealers, and they kept talking about this finish because it was the antique dealer's secret, where you could clean an old piece of furniture with soap and water, let it dry, and put a coat of Waterlox on it, not really alter the look of the piece at all. That's the other thing. Whenever you do this, you got to figure out a holding system, either putting nails at the end of the boards or some way to do it. I just, since I had these joints cut on the end, I just put a board to catch that joint. Yeah, you got to figure out a way And standing it up is generally not good because gravity makes the finish run, and you can't apply as much as you can if it's horizontal. If it's horizontal, you can really lay it on thick and really build your finish quickly. But as soon as you stand it up, gravity starts making it sag, and so you end up having to keep brushing it, and so you end up putting less on than you wanted to. Yeah, you can just brush this stuff. You can brush it and brush it until it's almost dry. And it just doesn't hurt it. The more you brush it, actually, the deeper you're forcing it into the wood grain. So now I'm gonna come in and get my joints. My brush is not saturated, it's just enough to give it a nice coat. Waterlox makes three grades of this type of finish, and they grade it by the percent solids that's in the finish. And I may be off, you could consult their website, but I think that this one, the Waterlox Original, which used to be called back in the day, it was called Transparent, I believe it's about 25% solids. And then they sell a product that they call High Gloss, which I really love, that used to be called Gym Finish. And it's 35% solids. And then they sell a Marine Finish that is about 50% solids. And I've used that too. And you can build a finish. But a lot of people don't care for such a glossy finish on furniture and woodwork. I love it. I think it just looks finished and really great, but most customers, they want that dulled down look. And I've used this, depending on if it's really, really hot or if I'm doing floors or really big surfaces, where, because the Waterlox dries really fast in hot weather. So to retard that a little bit, you can add Penetrol, which is a oil-based paint conditioner. It's a linseed oil-based product, and it will actually take the sheen down ever so slightly over the pure Waterlox finish. See, now I'm getting inside my groove with my brush. My brush doesn't have very much finish on it at all, so I'm not going to make a mess in there that's going to affect my fit. Just getting it sealed up in there. Doesn't need much, but it should be sealed everywhere. I love these foam brushes for just applications like this, just getting into corners. And see, that's perfect. If I would have gone in here with the brush completely saturated, I would have had just a mess down here that I would have had to then clean out. And the last thing I want to do is be sanding inside a groove to get too much finish out. So I got just enough finish on that brush just to coat it. Okay, I'm gonna just do one final brush down on these just to make sure everything is good and straight. So like I said, you can't brush this stuff too much. You just really want to drag it out to a uniform surface here.